This anime is so damn good. Without a doubt, my favorite anime that I'm following with this new winter 2020 season. It's insane to think we're already a fourth of the way through this anime, but the way they're pacing and structuring it is so spot on. So many times have you had an idea like this, a detective mystery, a really cool anime system that obviously we can't apply to the real world. They would basically drop all the information within its first two episodes, and people would roll their eyes and move on because it would just feel like an info dump. It wouldn't feel like there was any reason to watch, but if you did continue, you'd actually see the system in place in a really interesting way. But unfortunately, the intro episodes, they just didn't know how to structure and pace it. And I remember when the first two episodes dropped, there was a lot of people saying, "I don't understand how the system is working. I don't have all the answers." But of course we didn't, because it was just the first two episodes. But with each passing week, we get more of an understanding of the system that they use, how it operates, and the limitations and struggles that it does have. And I love that. Like with this week's episode, they casually talk about what can happen, how they track things, and how they can basically lose a criminal. Like they basically scan these particles from basically someone's brain, and not always can they find said particles. Somehow, some people, this massive grave digger who just lets people basically die in a hole as he live streams it, they can't track this person, and they mention how even like a gust of wind could blow the particles away. So they like casually drop the information instead of just saying, "Okay, it's time for a lecture. This is how the system operates. Do you understand? Any questions? All right, now let's get back to the story." But rather, as we have our main character in the well, which is basically a building on fire trying to save a little girl inside the tallest part, you just have the characters discussing, "Why can't we find this person? Why did we find him this time?" And in doing so, it creates a very natural flow, so we don't feel like it's info dump, but rather it's just these characters casually talking, and we understand the well mechanics and the basically invading someone's identity even better. I actually think this episode was probably my favorite of the series so far, because it was a very interesting concept for the well, because you have a character who apparently is the gravedigger, right? We finally caught him. He's killed like five people so far. We haven't been able to trace him. But this doesn't make sense. Why are we focusing on a well that is basically a building on fire? This is a person who buries people alive. So I wasn't sure what I was supposed to think there. I was actually very confused, and that's what I want to see, something that really makes me think. So every time he kept failing in the well, he would get blown apart by just opening a door. The building would catch on fire. He'd fall to his death. It was very interesting to see the characters very confused, as if they didn't want to believe they had the right person, because this makes no sense. This is the first time that we're able to find his location, because every time they've basically tried to locate the victims, they've had no luck. So he's a very good killer. But the idea that he was a copycat was actually a really nice twist, because the idea of someone basically copying someone's legacy but doing it for their own reasons, which in this case was a person who basically was trying to burn people alive, and he thought a little girl saw him, so that's why he was doing the whole copycat thing. It was actually a pretty genius crime for being as sick and twisted as it was, and I really appreciate how they were really going into Sakato and just how he truly operates. Like, this man is a serial killer by all rights of the definition, and the fact that this one person who kept looking like he was the hardest on him is actually his best friend, and he actually is incredibly worried for his partner there, I thought was a good way to really sell that this is a very tough system. Like, the fact that they are sending pretty much anyone in who can basically match the criteria, and to just see, like, can we have more people than just this one person be able to solve the crimes? But no one really has that detective luck the same way our main character does. And I thought it was so cool just to see how this is such an insane system. Literally, we will have our main character just jump in and out nonstop. The only time he really takes a break is to eat, because in that state, I mean, he actually has to be awake. But if he has to go to the bathroom, he'll just go inside the chair and he'll just keep on pushing. Like, the idea that this is such an insane system that you basically are killing someone just to try to find someone else to save, but because he's a criminal, they all pretty much just let it pass. And it's so interesting to see how broken, but also how different he is inside the well versus his current state. Because the person that we see in the well, who is very monotone, but he's also a happy person, as seen by when he thought he saved a little girl, he's definitely a normal person. That's who he was before basically his world came crashing down. But to see just how empty and lifeless, but also, I would say, how much of a venomous look he has towards people. He definitely lives up to the serial killer name that he's basically had, and how it's just depressing. Like, that's the best way to put it. It's depressing to look at this character, but it's also, you kind of want to see how far he can go off the deep end to see what that will really translate to. Because you have a friend who just hopes that he can save him, maybe stop him from wanting to kill. And just that conversation towards the end of the episode, he asks, "Do you want to kill this person?" And how he basically explains how he doesn't believe he's human, but at the same time, his friend is trying to say, "You are human, absolutely," and how the friendship is the only thing tying him to not completely go out the deep end. Like, there is just so much emotional trauma towards Sekhato, and I love seeing him in despair, but also I love seeing the possibility that maybe he could have a better life. But at the same time, I kind of want to see how far off the deep end he'll go, because based on the writing scene here so far, the way they've written same characters, I think it would be interesting to see. I mean, just the idea of this well was absolutely my favorite one, because rather than make it very obvious, like, okay, there's a sniper in a waterfall, right? Like, that's basically, we know what we're looking for. Here, a character buried alive, they introduce immediately what we were focusing on, not just like, okay, we're trying to find someone, and then when we find them, we understand what we're looking for. Here, they tell us a girl is buried alive. That is what's happening, so why the hell are we looking at a burned building? And I didn't see the copycat twist coming. I probably should have. It was pretty obvious in hindsight, but I like that. I really appreciate how the idea of the wells, it's not like he remembers when he comes into these wells. He is just the greatest detective, and if you replay a situation 50 times, if you have the ability to rewind, it's not guaranteed that you would interact with it the exact same, nor would the well interact in the same way. So just the slightest alterations where he gets blown off the building, he's able to hold onto a pipe. He didn't do it last time, but just this time he could. Just the idea of watching someone mentally struggle to that degree. Like, obviously inside the well, he's not struggling except when he gets killed, but every time he gets out of there, it's like, holy shit, this man is killing himself. And just the idea of revenge for him and what's driving him because of his family's death, like, that is so heartbreaking. But that's what you want to see in an anime like this. If this was just a character who had a very good life, maybe he struggled inside the wells, but he got to go home to his wife and kids, it wouldn't be nearly as engaging. But having to see a dead girl every single time you go into the well, and when you come out, you have to remember your own dead daughter, that is such an emotional pull and a really good hook to keep viewers engaged. And I am so happy that they didn't keep the concept on the wells as being like the same for each person. As when I first read the description and kind of like watched the preview, I thought every well was gonna look like episode one, where it would be kind of like this white space. Maybe there'd be a unique twist with each basically person or thing like that. But the idea that every single case that he's trying to solve has a unique flair to it is the reason that this anime will never grow stale, because every single time it will match the person's identity. And when he comes out of that, if they put him next to a cell that's just, across the hall or right next to him as neighbors, if he is pissed off with that person, they're going to die. Like, this man does not go out his way to kill, but just in the moment, he loses his cool and just he'll use the secrets that he found out about this person when he was inside their mind, their psyche, and will just drive them off the deep end. Like, this man is all about cold, hard revenge. And on one hand, I'm like, absolutely go for it, because look at what this person did to a little girl, starved her to death and live streamed it for the world to see. But on the other hand, you're like, don't go to their side, like, let them starve in a cell. There's so many conflicting feelings that I have about this anime, and when you just listen to the music, whether they're going into that more like detective music where you're like, you're curious, you're a little worried, but you're also a little optimistic, or they're just blasting some great samurai song when he's like running across a bridge, the production of this anime is really, really good. Like, the only thing that is a little disappointing is there definitely is some wider shots that are underwhelming for sure. But I mean, when you just look at how much detail is put into the backgrounds and how character reactions are with their body language, this anime slaps. Like, the only way that this anime would really struggle is if it was a two core. But since it's 13 episodes, like, the production should be pretty solid overall. And when they release the Blu-ray and DVD, I'm sure it'll look even better. Like, this show is so unique. And if it wasn't for anime like this, I wouldn't be as interested in the medium as I currently am. Because to have a show like this that constantly makes you think, constantly has you on the edge of your seat, and you are so emotionally invested into its central character, both as a frightening appeal, but also you just feel so bad for him. Like, that's what makes the show so great, and it's a damn shame not more people are checking it out. But I think, like, closer to when this anime ends, this show is probably gonna blow up in popularity. Like, there's a good amount of people watching, don't get me wrong, but it's not getting the same amount of attention as one of the mainstream shows. But I think if it continues to be this engaging, it absolutely will have that appeal in the long term. 100%, there's no doubt in my mind. This was a fantastic episode. It was visually interesting, it was emotionally interesting, and it was heartbreaking all in the process. I love how they are exploring the well system and how they're not just dropping their load in one episode. They're casually introducing these mechanics, and in doing so, it makes it feel like a natural transition from educational to the current crime at hand, and that's fantastic. What did everyone think of Invaded Episode 4? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop a like, and remember to hit that subscribe button if you're happy new round tiers. Until next time, everyone, please take care and have a good one.